Hello students, today we have got English lecture and in your textbook come to unit 3.2 and in your textbook page number 107 and the name of the lesson is The Night I Met Einstein. Now look students, over here some instruments are shown to us. Okay, I hope so you know the name of this instrument. What this instrument is called? It is called tabla. Then which is the next instrument below? It's your shehnai. Okay, over here it's piano, this is drum, over here this is violin, this is sitar, and this is a trumpet. So by looking at this musical instrument, let us get an idea that this lesson will be something related to music or something. Now, your next page, The Night I Met Einstein. I am reading the lesson. Students, please pay attention while I am reading the lesson. Now, when I was very young man, I was invited to dine. Dine means what? To have a dinner. At the house of a philanthropist. Philanthropist, you can say a rich person or a merchant or something. After a wonderful dinner, our hostess. Now, who's a hostess? A woman who invites guests to a social event is called a hostess. Took us to a large drawing room, a large place there which is called as a drawing room where people come and they sit and they enjoy over there. Chairs was been arranged. So what was there in the drawing room? Chairs were arranged. I am arranging the chairs for a concert, my hostess said. Now concert means what? Performance of music by players or singers is called concert. I am arranging the chairs for concert, my hostess said. We are going to listen to a very good pianist. You know what you mean by pianist? A person who plays a piano is called a pianist. Though, see, a person, someone who plays the piano is called a pianist. Though everyone else was very happy, I was not. So, who? The author was not happy, but everybody was happy. I did not understand classical music. And why the author was not happy? Because he was not able to understand classical music. I thought I was tone deaf. Tone deaf means unable to hear the difference between high and low notes. So in the music, we have got something called high notes and low notes. And this author was not able to understand. I sat down so that I would not be impolite and waited for the concert to begin. So the author sat in one particular place and it began, then the concert is going to start. I did not pay attention to the music after it began. After a while, I heard everyone clapping. So when they start clapping, when the performance was over and people started clapping. So I realized that the piece was over. So what the author thought, maybe the music is over. Just then I heard a gentle but firm voice saying, "You are fond of Bach." Now Bach means who? John Sebastian Bach, a German organist and composer of the 17th century. You know, person who composed music. So he was a John Sebastian Bach. I knew as much about Bach as I did about nuclear physics. So Einstein, what Einstein was knowing, he was knowing about physics. He was much more interested in science. I was going to say something ordinary so that I could get out of the situation. I turned in order to look at my neighbor and I saw a very famous face. It was some with a shock of white hair and a pipe. Pipe means what? In Western countries, there's a fashion of smoking, and how they smoke with a pipe. I knew that I must tell this man the truth. He looked at me as if my answer was very important. I do not know anything about Bach. About Bach means who that person is. This Bach was a German organist and composer. Who said this? The author told. I don't know much about Bach. I said, I have never heard any of his music. He looked surprised. You have never heard of Bach? He asked. He made it sound as if I had said that I had never taken a bath. I like to understand music so that I could understand Bach. I said, but I'm not able to. I am tone deaf. The old man got up. You will come up with me, he asked. I just remained seated. I am requesting you to come with me, he said again. So I went up with him. He took me to a room which had a gramophone in it and asked, what kind of music do you like? Now see, gramophone is a machine which is used for playing recorded music. That's the meaning of gramophone. Well, and see here the picture is shown of this gramophone. Well, I answered, I like songs that have words and the kind of music where I can follow my tune. So what the author said, I answered, I like songs that have words. He smiled and nodded. Nodded means what? To move head up and down. Obviously pleased. You can give me an example, perhaps. I told him I like anything by Bing Crosby. Now, who's Bing Crosby? He's an American singer and an actor. At once, I could hear Bing Crosby's voice filling the room. Now, can you please tell me what you just heard? He said. The simplest answer seemed to be to sing the lines, so I sang it back to him. He smiled. You are not tone deaf, he said. I told him this was one of my favorite songs, something I had heard hundred of times, so it didn't really prove anything. Nonsense, said Einstein. It proves everything. Do you remember your first arithmetic lesson in school? Suppose at your very first contact with numbers, your teacher had ordered you to work out a problem in, say, long divisions or fractions. Could you have done it? So here, Einstein is giving one example that when your teacher was teaching you maths, do you remember what she had exactly taught you in method of division or fractions? No, of course not. Exactly. It is learning maths. You have to learn addition and subtraction in order to do multiplication and division. Now I am playing something a little more advanced. So what this tells us, if you want to know something, what you should know basic of it. So here what the author is trying to tell us, that before you know something about the music, you should know basic about the music also. It was John McCormick singing the trumpeter. Sing that back, he ordered. And we went on from level to higher level until he was playing just music without words. I was amazed. Amazed means I was shocked that this great man was paying complete attention to me so that I could learn something new. It was as if I was the most important person in the world. Suddenly, he got up and turned off the gramophone. Gramophone means what? To turn off, means to switch off the gramophone. Now, young man, he said, we are ready to listen to Badge. We went down and sat in the hall. Just allow yourself to listen, he said. That's all there is to it. I've heard that piece many times since that day, but I am never alone. I am sitting beside a small man with a shock of untidy hair. Untidy hair means what? The hair which was not combed properly. Untidy hair and a pipe in his mouth. He has eyes that are usually warm. When the concert ended, I too was able to clap sincerely. Why I was clapping sincerely? Because he came to know what is the importance of music. Our hostess came towards us. We both stood up. I'm so sorry, Dr. Einstein, she said, giving me a cold look, that you missed so much. I am sorry too, he said. My young friend here and I, however, were engaged in the greatest activity of which a human being is capable. She looked puzzled. Really, she said, and what is that? Einstein smiled and put his arm across my shoulders, opening up the frontiers of beauty. Frontiers of beauty means what? How everything in life is important. So, today we will just summarize the lesson. Nazi. The night I met Einstein is a story that offers a lesson in life and music. So, how in life, music is important. From the most brilliant mind in the world. Many of us do not know Albert Einstein. To be a creative mind and a music lover. So, although he was a creative mind and he was a music lover also. This story captures the person of Einstein and shows us how to help and address a problem facing classical music. So, here we are not in the starting, we don't know anything about anything. So, we have to take a basic information. It is interesting that someone like Einstein shows a man the beauty of music. The narrator did not understand music and said he was toned off. So, the narrator, that is Jerome, was not knowing anything about music. He was getting bored at a concert. Einstein, who did not even know this young man, pulled him to a separate room and taught him to learn to love music. So Einstein, okay? Einstein was a lover of music, but the author, the narrator, was not interested in the music. He took him to one room and showed him how music is important. The narrator has penned down his experience about how to learn to appreciate music. So what this lesson is trying to tell us, that we should appreciate everything in our life, not only music. It can be anything, should be appreciated. That what the author is trying to tell us. Now, in this lesson, come to your page number 110, complete the following sentence, please do it. Then, who said to whom, do it. Question number 3. List all the words from the story, do in your notebook. Question number 4. Rewrite the following sentences. Do it. Give 2 points of difference between. Do the same. Question number 6. Do it. Question number 7. Question number 7 and 8. Grammar questions. Please do it. क्वेश्चन नंबर बी, गुड आई थिंक। क्वेश्चन नंबर नाइन, प्रिपेयर द वर्ड चेन। क्वेश्चन नंबर टेन, पिक आउट वर्ड्स दैट रिफर टू द फॉलोइंग, प्लीज डू इट। क्वेश्चन नंबर इलेवन, ट्वेल्व, थर्टीन एंड फोर्टीन आर ओमिटेड। सो व्हाट इज ओमिटेड? क्वेश्चन नंबर इलेवन, क्वेश्चन नंबर ट्वेल्व, क्वेश्चन नंबर थर्टीन, क्वेश्चन नंबर फोर्टीन आर ओमिटेड, प्लीज डोंट डू इट। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एंड प्लीज कीप ऑन रीडिंग योर टेक्स्ट बुक। थैंक यू।